Hello world and welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. My name is Colleen O'Brien and I'm here with my co-host Sonia Dara.
Hello.
And every week we're going to be taking a look at the stories of Microsoft technology and the people behind that technology. Sonia and I are each going to have secret stories. Sonia will have some stories that only she has read. I will have some stories that I have read.
You'll share your stories and then I'll share mine.
Excellent.
I'll synergize.
I love a good
other buzzwords.
Yes. Our hope is that these stories really inspire you, but also give you some great talking points to be the star of water cooler conversation. You know, those places where people might notice if you're a good chat.
You want to be a good chat. Is that like part of your New Year's?
It's an aspiration for me.
To be a good chat.
I always notice when people are good chat. Like, ooh, that person's a good chat.
So they're not a good chatter, they're just a good chat. Is that the terminology? Am I kidding?
Yeah, maybe my grammar is a little off here, but I think in my head, like, that person's a good chat.
That's good.
Yeah.
You can all be good chats, plural, I guess, after the end of this episode, so, and the series. Let's start with the first one. Well, what's our first topic, Colleen?
The theme of our episode today is mixed reality. So Sonia and I are going to be sharing stories of how mixed reality is showing up in different workplaces.
Okay, so there's VR, AR, MR. Virtual reality is when you can't see anything, so like Oculus Rift.
Correct.
Like it would be that you're fully immersed in a new world.
Augmented reality is taking like user interfaces or the apps that you use.
Jarvis. From Iron Man. Jarvis has all the tech, right? So, Iron Man.
Exactly. Exactly. So you're wearing some sort of headset and you can see this information that's pasted on the world around you.
Yes.
Mixed reality is really taking the best of both worlds.
You're invited to this. I'm having a bar crawl, 90s themed for my birthday. I'm 90s baby. I'm dressing up as Miss Frizzle, right? Yeah, so I had to buy some like extra swag for it. And one of them is the lizard. Like you have to get Liz the lizard. And normally I'd be used to seeing the images of where it'd be placed like in a setting like here or whatever and someone taking like stock photography. And instead it said, place it in your room. And I was like, what is this? And so I clicked the button and it actually was kind of like Windows Mixed Reality where you could place it in your room or on a table and it would actually adjust the size of the lizard.
Are you looking at a screen?
On my phone.
Okay.
Like literally on my phone. So I would like drop it on the like floor and I was like, okay, the shows are kind of small. Now I know it'll fit perfectly and my wig is also coming. Whole shebang.
Do you ever buy something and it's like so much larger than you thought it was gonna be?
Or it's like so much smaller. It's like people try to buy like a shirt and then it turns out it's like a shirt for a cat. And then they're like.
It's never happened to me.
There's plenty online about it.
Okay. I'm gonna be telling a story about Mercedes-Benz Global Training.
Ooh,
specifically
fancy.
Two gentlemen.
Okay.
Walter Bach and Ralph Krieger. I want you to think about Walter as, like maybe he's using a really old cell phone.
Like this is flip phone, maybe?
Precisely.
No? Okay.
Not necessarily technology's best friend.
Right, okay.
Ralph Krieger. Ralph always has the latest and greatest technology. He loves to, he's like a tech hobbyist. So these two together, they're a bit of an odd couple, you might say.
Not a lot of synergy.
Not a lot of synergy. Yet, they meet each other at a Mercedes-Benz Global Training program where they decide they're gonna team up. Walter has all of this great knowledge and history of the business. He's an incredibly thoughtful person, if not the most cutting edge. And then Ralph is bringing that technology to the table.
Yeah, he's got some fire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They decide to use these HoloLens devices in their global training program. So say you're a customer service person who's joining the team, you might run into Walter and Ralph in this training facility and they'll tell you, put on this HoloLens. We're gonna walk around the car and it's gonna show you all of the ins and outs, all of the intricacies of the transmission, of the engine.
Yeah.
You have this HoloLens on your head, you're walking around the car. What's the first place that you're gonna look?
I don't know why I thought trunk first, but that was that's the last place I would look. Probably the engine or the driver's seat.
To be honest, I thought glove compartment. I don't
know why.
I don't know, like a snack?
My parents always put caffeine pills. That was the only thing exciting in there. For long drives, caffeine pills.
Oh my gosh.
It's not that weird. Is it? Is it weird?
That's weird.
So our friends here, they're still using HoloLens on the job. They have 100 HoloLenses at each of their training locations, but he has really like dove into the experience and wears it when he's making salads at home.
What?
Like he
How
likes-
How much balsamic should I
I can't wait to buy my first car through a HoloLens experience. I think that
You're
would be
You're gonna buy
really
a
cool.
car.
I might.
Now that you know that
Now that I HoloLens. Know that I can use a HoloLens to do it.
That's awesome. So my first story also actually relates to HoloLens. In an equally exciting industry as cars, elevators.
Okay. Yeah.
And it's the world's first mixed reality stair lift solution. Mm. Courtesy of, and I'm totally gonna butcher their name,
ThyssenKrupp.
The Dutch company.
Yeah, they make all of the elevators. You don't
They're
know ThyssenKrupp?
Did you know how to pronounce it before this? Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, I'm an elevator aficionado.
Apparently. How do you spell it?
ThyssenKrupp.
What? How did you know that? Read the spelling bee or something? In Amsterdam?
To be honest, I lost the spelling bee when I was in fifth grade.
To what word?
Permanent. Is it permanent or permanent?
Ooh. I misspelled in the first grade fragile.
Fragile.
No, I put a J. ThyssenKrupp, the elevator company. They're partnering up with Microsoft HoloLens and they are creating the first fully digitized sales process for the stairlift industry. Back in the day, it used to take 40 to 70 days for someone to come in, map out this schematic of someone's house and or if it's a building, and what the stair would be to then actually create the proper system for a chairlift or a stairlift.
40 to 70 days
from the time a person first shows up, from the time that they get the manufacturer on hold, the sales rep, everything. It's a pretty urgent matter if someone might not be able to go upstairs, for instance, if their bedroom's upstairs, and like it's kind of a bummer. So now, by using HoloLens, they can have someone come in with a HoloLens, build out the schematic, basically, and like the blueprint of it, get into manufacturing, so then it can actually be implemented within 14 days.
So say I'm this person wearing a HoloLens, what's the process? Like what happens?
So they would go to their stairs.
Yeah.
I'm assuming they're only asking for this if they have stairs. And basically by using the HoloLens, they're able to take accurate measurements essentially of the entire staircase. They would be able to pull in a little bit more of like what the infrastructure would be required if it's mounted on the wall versus something more on the floor. And basically they're able to get all that information much quicker. And then the comms are paperless. So like it's so much quicker to send all those initial measurements to the back end team
right. That's
able to actually then build up and mock up what the solution would be and
right.
then send it to manufacturing.
Because it's not a list of measurements
numbers.
Or a list of numbers, it's like a physical map.
And it's more accurate. I think it's pretty cool. Like they're actually digitizing and it's like just a different use case scenario for mixed reality. I mean, you have like Mercedes-Benz, which is pretty cool, but you know, elevators, a lot cooler. And I think it's just really awesome to see us, like, you know, helping people out.
Don't be down on yourself. More people are riding in elevators than riding in Mercedes-Benz. Your story was relevant.
That's true.
Thanks. Mixed reality is really changing the workplace.
Yeah, and day-to-day life. Like from my retail purchases to elevators. I pointed there because there's an elevator right behind you.
Oh, I was like, I'm not an elevator.
<You're> not.
We have learned a lot from our stories, but there's a little bit more that I think we can learn here today. We're gonna transition now to Outside the Box, where we'll finally bring in our third character here, this box.
You thought it was just a prop, didn't you guys?
I'm gonna read a question. We're
okay.
making this up as we go along. You have 30 seconds to answer. So get those. Is it okay that I'm opening this?
I don't expect your hand to be that skinny to...
Okay, let's not talk about the weight of my hand.
No! You think your hand can fit through this?
All right, ready? What's the strangest family tradition in your family?
Oh, okay. We have a couple of weird ones. We can't cut our nails on Tuesdays or Fridays.
Why?
I don't know. Can't cut our nails on Tuesdays and Fridays,
Is
or your
like-
hair.
It's a superstition?
I think so. It's weird. Yeah. Oh, that's not necessarily a tradition, is it?
I mean, it's a tradition you celebrate every week.
Okay, weirdest tradition? We don't put up a Christmas tree.
Okay, the nail cutting one is weirder. Okay, now you can ask me a different, same question?
Yeah.
Different question.
Different question. It's not gonna be, those don't, like, won't be funny answers.
Don't tick the box. Duly noted. Colleen's question. 30 seconds on the clock, please.
30 seconds on the clock.
What was the first concert you ever went to?
The first concert that I ever went to was Green Day, the All-American, or the American Idiot Tour.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I went in Manchester, New Hampshire, lovingly referred to as Manch Vegas, because I grew up north of Boston in Woburn, Massachusetts, and it wasn't too far to, like, drive over to New Hampshire.
Mine was LaBouche.
Whoa!
You guys know what LaBouche is, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I went with my parents in, like, random. I was, like, probably, like, 8 years old.
Your parents were cool for bringing you to LaBouche.
I tell them that every time I see them.
Right now the box is pretty empty, so we're looking for questions that you might have for us. If you want to send us a question, just feel free to send it to the email below, and we'll get it into the box for our next show.
And finally, please subscribe to this channel, to the Microsoft channel, if you haven't already. Please subscribe, and we will be here every week, so please tune in, and we'll see you then.
Bye. Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles right here.